Hello, my YouTube friends. I'm going to share with you something interesting. It's a soft drink from Kentucky called Ale 8. Some other states have particular soft drinks that are only available regionally. This one began in 1926. The formulator was a man named G.L. Wainscott. And according to the website, he traveled through Northern Europe and became interested in ginger blends for soft drinks. So there's some ginger involved. He was a bottler of various types of soft drinks, and as the years went by, the company stayed in the family, and ever since 1926, it's been bottled in Winchester, Kentucky. Nowadays, it's available in Ohio, Indiana, and Kentucky. The only three states it can be purchased at retail, but they ship it all over, including to soldiers overseas. The name is unusual, Ale 8. Often in Kentucky, people will call it Ale 8. But the full name is Ale 8-1, and you can see at the top there, it says Ale 8-1 in quotes. Apparently, G.L. Wainscott sponsored a bit of a contest to figure out the name or the tagline. And a late one is supposed to mean that it was the latest thing in beverages. Or the hottest item. Well, I've been drinking it since I was born, basically. My family enjoys it. There's more of an iconic, original type of a bottle that it was available in. The cans are a relatively new advancement, so they come in 12 packs, also in plastic bottles, but there's a larger green bottle with a swooping vase design, and then a more conventional bottle that has kind of shoulders, more modern looking. Both of the bottles are green, and on the newer bottles, I think it's got a picture of the founder, the original brewer or bottler, I should say, the person who developed it, Mr. Wainscott. The can, though, unfortunately, is lacking any of those accents. You only get the logo, ingredient list, a couple other things. We'll run through it now together. The website there is ale81.com. I think they probably should have gotten a hold of easier website. So I'm not sure exactly what you have to key in, but I would just Google LA. Instead of worrying about all the dashes and things, it's a Kentucky Proud product. This is some kind of a promotional thing. Lots of people who make food items are listed through the Agricultural Department. And they will tag their stuff with this Kentucky Proud logo featuring a cardinal in mid-flight swooping into the air. So it's an attractive can. There's a speckled design that's apparent here with a light and a dark green. And it works nicely with the yellow bands and the red. The font is interesting. Kind of a custom classic font with the one hiding there on the side. It's almost like a punctuation rather than a one, like the number one. The latest thing in 26. It's a 120 calorie beverage and a product of the USA. It's not a ball can, but it's got a little crown here. That's probably the indicator of the aluminum manufacturer who makes the cans. Individually barcoded. And let's have a look now at the ingredients list. carbonated water, sugar, and corn sweetener. This is not an either or situation. Glycerine, natural and artificial flavorings, citric acid, sodium benzoate, a preservative, caramel coloring, phosphoric acid, and caffeine. And there's mention here that it's canned under the authority of L81 by an authorized producer. There is what may be a myth regionally that it's got lots of caffeine. I think it's probably comparable to the caffeine level in other soft drinks. It is, after all, the very last ingredient, even after phosphoric acid. So, by weight, there's more caramel coloring than caffeine, but I suppose you don't need much. Originally, well, the secret recipe is still in the family, so. Although I've been drinking it my whole life, I couldn't really readily tell you what the flavors are. And in the mythology surrounding the company, and, well, even regionally, there's not really too many clues as to what the other ingredients could be. On occasion, I buy these. I mentioned them in a review maybe a week ago, so that's why I purchased this 12-pack. But it's really only about once a year that I'll get a 12-pack of them. But the cravings for L8 will set in every once in a while, so I'll drink them every few months, maybe every 3 months or so. I'll spontaneously buy one, and I have had moments when I was extremely refreshed by swilling one in the morning, or when I was especially thirsty. So there's a fondness that I have for this product. I can say without hesitation that it's my favorite soft drink. I'm not too much into colas or sodas or pops. There are a few of them that I do like, but something about the hometown vibe of this local stuff. I do have a lot of family in Winchester, and I've spent a lot of time there. It's in Clark County, Kentucky. It's a city, it's a small city that's about, well, to get from the city proper into Lexington city proper, it'll take you probably about 45 minutes. Lexington is one of the two largest cities in Kentucky, so there's a lot of traffic back and forth on a road called Winchester Road, which is a beautiful road. You can see lots of rolling hills and drive through the horse farms. Kentucky is a beautiful state, and the country drives that are available are pretty striking. L8 to me is a good beverage. The flavor's agreeable. I'm not picking up too much of a ginger taste, though. It is extremely subtle and blended, it seems, in equal portion with other things that I really cannot place. To me, it's got a little bit of a heavy, syrupy kind of a taste, and the predominant flavor is kind of these sweeteners, which makes sense because it's the major ingredient after water. I'm not certain what the glycerin does, how that affects the mouthfeel or the sensation or the flavor, but I struggle to believe that glycerin was one of the heavy flavoring agents back in Wainscot's day. It displeases me that there are artificial flavors involved. It's probably just a like most companies, they search for ways to do things cheaper. But if the company was my own company and I had been reared in that environment, I certainly would probably strive to use natural things. I suppose it's probably harder to control quality. You couldn't really get as uniform of a product probably using naturally derived substances. But there's got to be some ginger in there somewhere. So, who knows what's really in it? The sweetness isn't overwhelming. It really does kind of offer refreshment. So, it's light enough. The carbonation's not very heavy. I should have brought a glass jar in here to give you a look at the color, but it's kind of an off, well, it's kind of like a burnt yellow, kind of like a really thinned out maize color, like straw, really light straw yellow. So the caramel color here that's mentioned, it may be just drops per vat, because caramel color often finds its way into sodas and cola pops, which are very, very dark, but this it's more of a grassy, a straw grassy color. I'll pour a bit so you can see in the glistening light into my dinosaur mug. See, it's quite light. Looks good in the glass. I like these cans. I'm a big fan of cans overall. I'm wary of aluminum because of the threats of like brain problems. It's still up in the air. I wish we would get a definitive idea from science whether actually it does lead to Parkinson's or Alzheimer's. Since medical science is so vague, there probably are direct links. I also worry about my Sunbeam Hotshot, which I really feature in a lot of videos. It has kind of an aluminum heating area, and it's very quickly brought to a high temperature, so if anything was going to leach out of it, it would probably come from that very rapid heating of through like a coil, which heats the or a coil element, which heats the aluminum. So, but I didn't really see any glass bottles available for sale. Just a big old rack of bricks of these L8s. And it's good if you're ever in Kentucky. I think maybe the only other regional product that I feel a great attachment to and desire for and a drive to acquire when I'm around it is Primanti Brothers sandwiches in Pittsburgh. And those are good. You know what a great combo it would make to have a cold L8 and a hot Primanti Brothers sandwich? You know, that might make for the best meal of the entire year for me. I don't anticipate any road trips in 2014 to the Northeast, but I can also highly recommend Primanti Brothers, Primanti's. In Pittsburgh, it's a tradition. It's very old. I didn't look up the history. I didn't really plan to talk about it, but Primanti Brothers is, they use a slaw, which they put on the sandwich itself, and it's kind of a sandwich that also features French fries on the sandwich itself, making for a unique experience, and tomatoes. And the bread's quite good. You can look it up online and really, really feel your glands in your mouth start salivating. Because I like, it's a unique slaw. It's not kind of like a fast food slaw that you'll find at a lot of fast food restaurants. It's much better. So I'm going to keep sipping on this L8 for a couple more minutes. Just wanted to share that with everyone. If you have a great desire to have it, they ship it anywhere. It'd be a bit pricey to get it that way, though. I guess the tasting notes. I like the thinness of it. I like how the, although sugar is kind of the predominant taste, it's well in the background, so it's not overwhelmingly sweet. And I wish I had more tasting notes, but perhaps my palate, after having been coated with this beverage for 33 years, I would be curious to find out what an outsider thought, or maybe like a poll, what a poll would reveal if you gathered 100 people and all gave them an L8 and asked them to tell you what flavors they could pick out of it or how they felt about it. That's what's exciting about discovering new places. Come across things like L8. My favorite soft drink. If it's possible, give it a try.